She was serving these people at this house. So this was a very little boy at that time. And the holy people, they came to perform some ritual. For a few months they stayed with this house, with this family in this house. And this boy was also made to serve these holy people during this time. And these holy people were impressed by the gesture of the boy, a very little boy of this age of 7 years, which is the age for playing and for that. But this little boy was so absorbed from the ritualistic procedures of these holy people, and he served them by all his means, by his heart. He got immersed in the service of these people. So they were so pleased, and they called this boy and said, "We are very pleased by your attitude of service. So we wish to initiate you into the Lord consciousness by giving you a mantra." Then they have given him, they have initiated him by Vishnu mantra. That was the first step. And Bhagavatam ante emito anetundi oka sari kotta vaallu kuda vacharu kabatti vaalla bhashalo kuda vaallaku ardham ayindi cheptamani mana vaalliki chaala mandiki ardham avutundani cheptanu anamata. ఎలాగో మన వాళ్ళకి ఇంగ్లీష్ అర్థమవుతుంది, ఎక్కువ తెలుగు కంటే ఇంగ్లీష్ అర్థమవుతుంది. అందుకని వాళ్ళకి కూడా పాపం ఎంతో ఆసక్తి వచ్చారు. అందుకని భాగవతం ఎందుకు ఇందులో ఏమిటనేటువంటిది కొంచెం ముందుగా వాళ్ళు చెప్పడం కోసం ఇంగ్లీష్లో చెప్తాను. సో వాట్ ఈస్ దిస్ విష్ణు మంత్ర? హూ ఈస్ దిస్ విష్ణు? ఈజ్ ఇట్ మియర్లీ ది నేమ్, ఏ నేమ్ ఆఫ్ ది లార్డ్? వీ జనరల్లీ అండర్స్టాండ్ all these are proper nouns just like our names, but these are not like that. The Lord, the one Lord, is called by different names due to different functions, is different capacities. That is what you find in this wisdom. So he is called Vishnu because he is all pervading. The Lord of pervasion, that is called Vishnu, because he pervades everything in this universe, every atom, every object, every person, every living being, every so-called non-living being. Everything is pervaded by the Lord. So because he is the Lord of pervasion, he is called Vishnu. In Sanskrit, Vish means to pervade. So Vishnu Vyaptav, that is called, that is explained in Sanskrit. So he is called Vishnu because he is the Lord of pervasion. He pervades the whole universe, every atom and everything. He is the indweller of everything, every being, everything in his creation. Why, how he is the, he happened to be the indweller of every being and everything, every atom? Because everything is in himself, in the Lord only, Lord consciousness. Everything is dependent into the Lord consciousness. Nothing is devoid of this Lord consciousness. That is why he is called Vishnu. So this was the Vishnu mantra with which these holy people have initiated this boy, little boy, and instructed him to keep using this mantra and keep meditating and get into the experience. And for this boy, it did not take much time. Very easily he got into this experience, and this by this they were much more pleased and said, you already got into the first step, you could experience the Lord as the pervading light in everything. So this boy could see the Lord of pervasion in these holy people, in his mother, in the owners of this family, in everything and everybody. For him, it is the Lord himself that is pervade, that is existing. Into that experience he got very easily. Spontaneously he got into this. And then these holy people were so much pleased and impressed by this. And then they have initiated him into the second step. And the second mantra is Vasudeva mantra. Who is this Vasudeva? Why we always call Vasudeva? What does it mean? Vasudeva means the Lord who is expressing himself in the form of the behavior of the beings, and who is the substratum for every, the whole universe, for every being and for everything in this universe. That is called Vasudeva. Vasanad Vasudevasya. So Vasa means to, he is the substratum, he is there as the substratum, he is the Adhara. The Lord is the substratum. Without the Lord there is nothing in this creation. So Vasudeva he is called. So how to worship this Lord? It is not just only by meditating the Lord presence everywhere, but also to meditate the behavior of the other person as the expression of the Lord himself. This is very difficult, it is not so easy. Because the behavior of the other person with us, with yourself, is something which doesn't give only always the same experience. The other person, if he behaves in a manner in which we expect, then we can see the Lord in him. But if the other person does not behave according to our expectation, the other person behaves differently than how we expect, then can you accept that this is also an expression of the Lord? That is very difficult thing. We can accept that the Lord is pervading everything in this creation. But it's not so easy to accept that every behavior, every expression of the other person is also the expression of the same Lord. This is what is called Vasudeva Upasana. So it may take some 100 births or 1,000 births, or it may take very long time for us to attain this. But for this boy, the second step also was very easily attained. So the second step also very easily attained. And this was very pleasing for these holy people. And therefore they have initiated him into the third step also. The third step is by third mantra, which is called Narayana. Who is this Narayana? Who is Vishnu, who is Vasudeva, and who is Narayana? So Vishnu is the indweller of everything, that is Vishnu. Vasudeva is The Lord who is expressing himself as the behavior of the all the other persons around us. But who is this Narayana? This Narayana is the ultimate existence, which we call I am. Every being and every atom experiences this I am as the inner consciousness. And this I am is not different from the one I am of this universe. And when you see others, how you experience this Narayana is, whenever you see anybody, any others, you see yourself in the form of the others. That is the ultimate thing, ultimate experience. So when I see you, I see myself in that form. That is the highest experience. That is what is called Narayana. So this is the highest experience, and this boy within no time got into this experience very easily. When this takes so many births for the practitioners, for this boy it was very spontaneous. He got all these three initiations, he got into the experience very easily. And then he could see him, everything, everybody, as the Lord who is dwelling in him, and as the same Lord, that means himself in every person. So he has no attachment to anything, except the, he has only this experience. So these holy people, then he left from, they left from there, and then this boy, his mother also for him is the form of the Lord only. So he is not attached to the mother, but he never detached himself from his mother. This is very important thing. When we get into divine experience, we try to detach ourselves from those who are attached to us. But here Narada, even though he got into the highest experience of this Narayana, so for him there is nothing left. Everything is the same experience. His mother is also Narayana. So he has no attachment as a mother, but only experience of Narayana. But his mother is attached to him. So you are not expected to detach or prevent others when they are attached to you. This is very difficult to understand. So he never left his mother because he is detached. For him, his mother is also Narayana, but he never wanted to leave her. But when he attained this stage, then according to the divine plan, the mother left her body, the mother died. Then he was never sad by this also, because for him, birth and death are the same, there is no difference. And it's a divine plan. So when the mother left the body, then he was walking and moving on, experiencing the Lord in everything, everywhere. He has no limitation. Like this he was walking. And at certain stage, when he was experiencing this divine light everywhere, and this once in his mind he got a little idea, a proposal, that this divine experience should be there always. And when this came into his mind, he got separated from the Lord experience. For within a flash of time, he got separated from this. He lost this Then he felt different, separated from the Lord consciousness, Lord experienced himself. All this time, he and his experience are one and the same. But now, within this flash of time, he got separated because of this idea which came into his mind. And then he got very much anxious, because when once you get separated from the divine experience, very difficult to bear this. Then he was running in search of the Lord once again to get into this experience from which he got detached. And then he was going and going and running. He was calling the Lord. And then he could listen the voice, the divine voice of the Lord. Then the Lord said, when you are immersed in the experience, when you got an idea which separated you from the divine experience, then you have to once again wait for some time to get into the experience. And that is not possible for you in this body. That is what the Lord said. Then you have to wait for some more time until I give you a divine form. Not just a material body, but a divine body. Where you can be stabilized in the divine experience forever. And then this boy, after this kalpa has ended, in the starting of the next kalpa, Lord has given him a divine body, a divine form. And then he always got stabilized in this divine experience, that is Narada. So why Narada has given his own story in the beginning of this Bhagavata is to explain us that how one can once again drop down by getting detached from the divine experience. And once again, when how can you get into this divine experience? Because that is the ultimate thing for everyone, for every being, everyone. When we get stabilized in the divine experience, there is nothing more left. We always live in that. So that is why this story of himself from his previous incarnation was given as the beginning story in Bhagavata. That is how Narada has given his previous story. So thus, this is the beginning of Bhagavata, the holy scripture. And this first part of this Bhagavata gives many more things. How the real devotees, they worship the Lord, how they surrender themselves and accept everything that is given by the Lord. The mother of Pandavas, Kunti, praises him. This Bhishma praises him. And how they are devoted. All this is given in this first part of this Bhagavata, this holy scripture. So now it is time for us for the next program which follows. That is the cultural program. Now, we have a wonderful cultural program. The classical dance, a very classical dance